There's something in the Bahrain air tonight, and I'm not just talking about the sand. Our brightest minds have thrust their brightest ideas into the spotlight of the Sakhir circuit this evening as we look ahead once more to a Grand Prix that has thrilled us so consistently in the past. There's no shortage of passing opportunities around the 3.36 miles of the Bahrain International Circuit, with the best at Turn 1, of course, and then another soon into Turn 4. 15 corners here, 6 to the left and 9 to the right, and we could see one or two flat spots into the tight left-hander of Turn 10. Bahrain has showed us many times in the past, though, Anthony Davidson, that a good strategy will only take you so far. Beyond that, you need good racecraft and you need good consistency.
And a little bit of luck too, I'd say. This is one of those circuits where the safety car always seems to come out just at the right time to condense the field together and mix up the cars on different strategies. It's hard on brakes, it's tough on fuel, and the main overtaking opportunity is down into Turn 1, where it's easy to outbrake your opponent and potentially have a bit of argy-bargy as well.
Well then, after an exciting qualifying session yesterday, let's take a look at how the cars line up. An immense lap from Lewis Hamilton yesterday puts him on pole position, edging out Raikkonen, who'll start P2. Looking down the rest of the grid, we have Vettel, De Vries, Max Verstappen, and Bottas, Ricciardo, Hülkenberg, Alonso, and Sergio Perez, Grosjean, Sainz, Kevin Magnussen, and Van Dorn, Gasly, Ocon, Lance Stroll, and Sergei Sorokin, Ericsson, and Charles Leclerc rounds off the grid. And with preparations almost complete, let's head down to the track.
You managed to qualify better than we expected yesterday, so let's do the same again today. Thank you. ERS deployment. It's time to use some of this charge. Thank you. Stay clear of the white line on the exit. Receive a penalty for dangerous driving if you cross over into the track. Pierre's currently in P5. They're on old super softs. The time last lap was a 1:37.1. Turn up the ERS deployment and burn some of this energy. Pierre is in for his stop. Thank you.
Thank you.
Charges high. Let's increase ERS deployment to up the pace. Is looking really good. You're managing it well. To the car behind is 1.8 seconds. 2.3 seconds. They're on old softs. The time last lap was a 1:35.7. Be careful, we think you're going to start losing some tyre grip around now. The gap to the car ahead is 5.0 seconds. Signs is stopping now. We want to pit this lap, so push now. Pierre is in the pits. Is 2.8 seconds. Charge is low. If we turn down the ERS deployment, we can harvest more energy. Don't forget, box this lap. To speed now. Let's get some heat into those tires. Be careful with the front wing. You've taken some minor damage. ERS deployment. It's time to use some of this charge. Thank you. virtual safety car is out. Reduce speed and maintain a positive delta. Slow down, slow down. Your delta is negative, which means you are too fast. Reduce your pace. VSC ending, we're going green. Maintain positive delta until the green flags. Green flag. Some information on Magnussen. They have some kind of mechanical problem. Wing damage. Box for a new one. Okay, we can take you this lap. flag. Let's turn up the ERS deployment and burn some of this energy. Over. Take care of the car on the way in.
A great win then for the Maranello team today. Tell me, Ant, what was the key to this success?
Well, I think the track conditions just really suited their car today. Wind, track temperature, you name it. These cars come alive when the tyres are just at the right temperature. So the more easily you can keep them there, the better your race tends to go. And that's exactly what happened. Their car just looks so comfortable out there.
So here they come now, out onto the podium. Wherever you go, anywhere in the world, the Prancing Horse flags are dominant in the grandstands, and they're out in force again today. It's Ferrari on the top step once more. And now let's take a look at the driver's standings. It wasn't the best weekend for our championship leader, and their advantage at the top has been reduced. Moving on to the driver of the day then. Anthony Davidson, who would you go for?
Probably Stoffel Vandoorne. You know, strong pace, good work with the strategy, just a very complete drive, I think.
And now let's take a look at the constructors' standings. Ferrari extend their lead at the top of the championship. Meanwhile, a strong weekend from Red Bull this time out, and they improve their position in the championship. Well, what a weekend that has been. Please join us next time for another thrilling installment of this Formula One season.